Praise the Lord, church. Praise the Lord, church. Hallelujah. We welcome you in the sanctuary this morning. What a mighty God we serve. We are so grateful and thankful for the angels of God that are in this house, those that are looking down from down on heaven on us on today. We welcome you to our All Saints service. It's a time of remembering those who have gone on before us. It's a time of acknowledging our communal loss. It's a time of celebrating all that God has done in the lives of those saints that we know and the saints that we don't. And so as we prepare our hearts and minds to worship God, I pray that whatever you brought to church with you this morning, whatever you are watching with online, that you are able to lay it down at the feet of the cross this morning. My prayer for you today is that on All Saints Day that you know that there is a God who said, in my Father's house, there are many mansions. I would not have told you unless it were true that I go and prepare a place for you. And so on today, we thank God for that place that's not made by human hands. On today, we thank God for the legacy of this church and how we still have a yet praise on the inside of us. And with that yet praise, I'll turn it over to the praise team to set us off in worship.
Hallelujah. Come on. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Come on, stand to your feet and help us praise the Lord this morning. Somebody shout God glory. Our God.
Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above. We win some power and love. Our God is an awesome God. Our God is an awesome God. He reigns from heaven above. We win some power and love. Our God is
say it
awesome
again.
God.
Say our God.
Took away the fear.
Now we praise you.
Tell him
he reigns.
He reigns.
Well, come on and praise an awesome God this morning. Give God glory because he's worthy of all the praise. Hallelujah.
Good morning, saints. What a beautiful, beautiful day this is. And looking out over the audience, I can tell you, you are a beautiful group of saints this morning. I'm here to do the prayer this morning. I'm going to ask that you pray with me and pray for me as we all pray together. Oh, gracious, eternally heavenly Father, Lord, we come before you this morning in humble admiration, saying, Father, we thank you for keeping us throughout the night and protecting our minds that we may awaken this morning to a glorious sunlight. We thank you, oh Heavenly Father, for just being in our midst this morning. We thank you, Father, for just allowing us to be called your children. And oh gracious Heavenly Father, we humbly and honorably come to you this morning and say, Father, we are so grateful. We woke up this morning with an attitude of gratitude. And we ask your Heavenly Father to be with us throughout this day. Help us to stay in your will. And oh gracious Heavenly Father, help us to love and understand and to respect each other. And oh gracious Heavenly Father, we ask you this morning to be with the sick and shut in wherever they may be. Oh Heavenly Father, some stand in need of a special touch from you. Some stand in need of a mind regulation. And some stand in need of just your loving arms around them to let them know that you have not forgotten them. And oh gracious Father, we would be amiss if we didn't ask for a special anointing this morning upon our pastor. We ask your Heavenly Father to give her what she stands in need of this morning. Fill her belly with your word and let it come forth like a fountain overflowing, and let it not fall on fertile ground. And oh gracious Heavenly Father, we ask you to be with our world leaders today, Lord. We ask you to ride and to guide and to lead them in the direction in which you would have them to go. And help them, oh Heavenly Father, to understand that you are in control and not them. And oh gracious Heavenly Father, be with our bereaved this morning, Father. Put your loving arms around them. Comfort them late in the midnight hour. And let them know, Father, that they are not forgotten. We ask your Heavenly Father this morning to be with those that are in nursing homes. Oh, Heavenly Father, let the staff understand that they too may be in this same situation one day, and to remember to treat those that they are treating with kindness and with understanding and with the utmost respect. Because, Father, one day the tide will turn. And, oh, gracious Father, we ask you this morning to go by the prisons. There's someone there calling out for you, oh, Heavenly Father. Let them know that you were there and that you're there listening to their cry. And, oh, gracious Father, when our work here on earth is done, we ask that you grant us asylum with you. And oh gracious Heavenly Father, continue to bless this church, bless each member. These and all other blessings I ask in the name of your Son Jesus. Let the church say amen, amen, and amen. Thank you.
Come on, give God some more glory. Anybody stand before God with an even me praise? Even me. Sometimes I don't say what I'm supposed to say. Sometimes I don't do what I'm supposed to do. But he still blesses me. Even me, in spite of it all. Come on, give God some praise. Lord, I hear of.
Lord, I hear of.
Showers of blessings.
Showers of blessings.
Thou art scattering.
Thou art scattering.
Showers of thirsting.
Showers of thirsting.
Souls refreshing.
Souls refreshing.
Let some drops now.
Let some drops now.
Fall. Showers of blessings.
Showers of blessings.
Thou art scattered.
Thou art scattering.
Full and free.
Full and free.
Showers of thirsting.
Showers of. Souls refreshing.
Let some drops now.
Let some drops now.
Fall.
Fall on me.
Even me. Let some drops.
Let some drops now fall on me.
Even me. Even me.
Even me.
Oh, let some drops.
Let some drops now fall on me.
Come on, even me, Lord, even me.
Even me.
Even me.
Even me.
sing, oh God. Even me, say,
even me, Lord, even me.
Oh God, let some drop.
Let some drop down.
Even me,
even me, Lord, even me. Let some drop down.
Follow me. One more time, even me, oh God, say,
even me, Lord,
even me, in spite of me, even me, let some drop. Somebody ought to give God glory, because no matter what it looks like, if you just go to the rock, even a wretch like you and me, come on, God is still in the midst. No matter what you're going through, no matter what the trouble is, no matter what it might look like, God still has you. God will still keep you. Come on, even me. Somebody give God an even me praise. Come on, one more time like you mean it. Say, even me.
Even me.
Let's give God an even me praise. Let's give God an even me praise. Even me, God, I'm worthy of love, God. Even me, God, I'm worthy of healing, God. Even me, God, I'm worthy of saving, God. Even me, God. Even me. I don't know what you've been through, but even you. God knows every hair on your head. God knows every situation you've been through. God knows what hell you've been through this week, last month, and last year. Even you, God will give you your peace in the midst of a storm. God will give you joy when you think you have none. God will give you hope in a hopeless situation. Even you, no matter how much you have sinned, no matter how many times you turned your back on God, even you, God will meet you exactly where you are. Even you. Even you. Sometimes we just gotta say, God, we thank you. Because even a wretch like me, you would save. Even when I feel not worthy, God, God, you continue to say, even me. Don't you know that God continues to open up his arms wide to say, you are loved, you are seen, you are known. Even you. It doesn't matter if somebody called you horrible, bad, or you have done something that made you feel ashamed, or somebody has done something to you that you have felt shame for. Even you. Do you know God loves you this morning? Do you know that God loves you just how you are, but doesn't love you to keep you the same way? We're just taking a moment just to recognize the presence of Almighty God that loves you, that knows you by your name, knows every hair on your head, knows every step you'll take before you take it. And says, even you, I love you in spite of you, even you. So this morning, as we continue to worship God, I just want everybody just to continue to have an even me testimony on today. Even me, God. Even me. At this time, I want to invite Brother Julius Jennings up to offer us the children's moment. So we ask all of our children to come forward at this time. All of the children in the house, would you come forward at this time? Amen. 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 Come on down. For my bigger kids, can you just sit on the little cushion down there? Yeah, thank you. Yep. Come on up top, yeah. Can you stand up real quick? Can you stand up real quick? Stand up real quick. Oh, you never mind. She got it. Actually, yeah. How we gonna do this?
Come up.
Come on this side. Sit down, Malcolm. Sit down. Sit down, Malcolm. There you go. Watch out. Can you? Got it?
All right. Good morning. What? Nothing? Good morning. Good morning. Little bit more. Good morning. Okay. That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. All right. So today's theme is going to be don't complain, pray. Okay? So don't complain. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. So I have two scriptures first, and then we're going to get into a little story, okay? All right, so the first scripture, it says, do everything without grumbling or arguing so that you may become blameless and pure. Then you will shine among them like stars in the sky. That's Philippians 2, 14 through 15. I'm sorry, chapter 2, verses 14 through 15. And then the second scripture of the day is rejoice! In our confident hope, be patient in trouble and keep on praying. All right, so for the story, there is a children's book out there called Where the Sidewalk Ends. It's kind of an older book, and this book is filled with all the kinds of little stories and poems, and one of the poems in there is called Mr. Grumble Dump's Song. All right, so yes, before I read this poem, can you make a grumpy face for me? Does anyone have, like, grumpy? Let me see. Grumpy. You got to go? That's a grumpy one. More grumpies. All right. So when you are grumpy, how do you feel? What are you doing? What happens when you're grumpy? Anyone got any thoughts? Bad?
Bad.
That's a good one. Yes, sir. What you got?
Sad.
Sad? Yes, I can be sad and grumpy. Any other things that make us grumpy? Big kids, I know y'all got one.
Not getting enough rest.
Yeah, exactly. I was going to say, waking up too early, yeah, catch me at the wrong time. That's a problem. All right.
You got different stressors or frustrations.
Different stressors or frustrations. I like that. They can start weighing on you, make you grumpy, and you just that frown is there. All right, so let's read about Mr. Grumple Dump's song. So here we go. Everything's wrong. Days are too long. Sunshine's too hot. Wind is too strong. Clouds are too fluffy. Grass is too green. The ground is too dusty. The sheets are too clean. The stars are too twinkly. The moon is too high. Water's too drippy. Sand's too dry. Rocks are too heavy. Feathers are too light. Kids are too noisy. The shoes are too tight. Folks are too happy singing their songs. Why can't they see? Everything's wrong. All right. So do you think Mr. Grumple Dump is in a good mood? Yes or no?
No.
Very good. That's a great answer. So I would call Mr. Grumpy Dump a big old complainer. I'm guilty. I've done it before. And so guess what? Let's go back to the scriptures, okay? So the first believers had to deal with complainers too. Because in the verse we read that earlier, Paul is writing a letter to the church members in Philippi telling them to not complain. Don't argue. He said, as Christians, we should have cheerful hearts and willing minds so that we can shine and be like a light to the world. So sometimes, listen, I'm telling you, sometimes it's really, really, really hard to shine when I'm grumpy. And so that's why we can pray. We can pray, y'all. We can go to God in prayer. And so this is the second scripture where Paul was telling the Roman church to rejoice. Can you guys rejoice? What does rejoice look like?
Rejoice!
Anyone else? We got a rejoice for me? Give me a rejoice praise. Rejoice?
Rejoice.
Even when we're mad, say rejoice.
Rejoice.
Yes, yes. One more time. Oh, okay. You got one?
Rejoice.
That's right. All right. Thank you. So we can rejoice in our confident hope. We can be patient in trouble, and we can keep on praying. So whenever you feel yourself becoming a Mr. or Mrs. Grumble Dump, don't forget that we can pray. We can cast all of our troubles at the Lord's feet, okay? And so I have two things before we line up and go with Miss Michelle. We got a song, and I'm sorry, big kids. I didn't know it'd be so many up here because y'all don't want a sticker book, okay? I'm just going to call it. And I got sticker books, okay? So I'm going to have to figure out something else for y'all. But for the little ones, I got sticker books. Do y'all like stickers?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Okay. I'll give them. All right. So here's the song, okay? So if you're grumpy, I'm going to say something, then I need you to repeat after me. So if you're grumpy.
If you're grumpy.
That's what's up. Say, you can pray.
You can pray.
And you can shine all day.
You can shine all day.
Okay, so everybody, if you're grumpy. You can pray, and you can shine all day. One more time. Thank you, guys. So if you're grumpy, you can pray, and you can shine all day. Thank you, guys. Big round of applause. Thank y'all. Thank you. All right, so I believe there is a church school. So once you guys line up over there, you will have your sticker books there waiting for you. Thank you, Miss Natasha. All right, so line up. Go that way. That's right. Careful, Aaliyah.
Praise the Lord, church. Hallelujah. We want to thank Julius for that dynamic children's message. I want to make sure you guys are remembering what he said. He said, if you're grumpy, you can
Okay, and you can shine, come on, all day. Amen, amen. That's a lesson, that's a lesson. I have a few announcements today, but I want to call up first Marquand, who's going to speak about the last event that we have. If Maya can swing around as well to give us some information on her new ministry, I appreciate it. Amen. Let's receive them right now. Amen.
Good morning, church. I want to, from the bottom of my heart, thank every single last person that came out and made our event on Tuesday as big and as wonderful as it was. I think I've had a couple people come by and tell me it's like one of the best they've seen here. And I'm just thankful. Thank you all so, so much. Well, you know how when sometimes you get to that last, it's like the umpteenth hour, and you're looking around and you're like, okay, it's not the way I thought it was, but we're going to make it work. And then when you pray on it, you open your eyes, and what happened, happened. I had no candy. I had no candy Sunday. I have a pallet of candy that's still left over that I'm trying to find a way to get rid of it. I just want to thank you all so much between the cars, the activities, the amount of kids, the outpour. I thank you all from the bottom of my heart. Look forward for the teens to have a little field trip coming up soon. I'm going to be reaching out to those parents of those in 10 years old and up. So just look out for a call from me or a little nudge because I might need some help. But thank you all once again and God bless.
All right. Good morning, church family. So I am here this morning to introduce the new ministry we are starting right here at Asbury Town Neck. This ministry is called the Young Achievers Ministry. Okay, clap it up. And in this ministry, we aim to inspire, nurture, and support students through academics and to ensure high scholastic confidence and achievement. So what exactly does this mean? So we are going to make sure that the next generation has everything that they need to be successful academically and professionally. Okay. Amen. We're going to work with those in elementary, middle, high school, and college to make sure that they are prepared to advance to the next level. And let's keep it real. The students here do not lack potential or drive. Sometimes it's lack of resources, accountability, exposure, and sometimes they just need a little more encouragement. So this ministry will work to bridge the gap between seasoned members and young members of this church and community. So we will have three main sectors within this ministry. Number one will be subject-based tutoring, which will focus on math, science, social studies, English, reading and comprehension. And just so, this is a side note, just so you know, for those who are in Anne Arundel County, Anne Arundel County does offer virtual tutoring. So for those parents who are not able to help their students or help their children, they do offer virtual tutoring, and sometimes they are just sitting up there waiting. So that's the first sector. The second sector is going to be college readiness, which is going to focus on college applications, college essays, prep, review, scholarship applications and assistance, SAT and ACT prep, as well as bringing back college tours. And we also have a few guidance counselors in the house, so they know the subjects and the electives that need to be taken in order for our students to be prepared for college. And the last sector is going to be professional development. Amen. And this is where we will help with building up resumes, professional and public speaking, time management, mock interviews, how to obtain an internship, and how to get a return offer, as well as business etiquette. Some of the workshops that we're going to be focusing on is how to study. So I know a lot of times we tell our students, you need to study, but no one knows the tricks, techniques, in order to study and how to retain the information that you're learning. PowerPoint 101, Excel 101, there's some students in here who don't want to go to college. They don't aspire to go to college, and that's okay. We have some people in here who focus on trades. So we're also going to have some seminars on trades. Financial literacy, this is more so for the parents, how to save for college and how not to get all of these student loans under your belt right after you graduate. And we're also going to focus on career fairs. So I know I gave you a lot of information and we have a lot planned, but there is room for all of those who want to be a part. If you are interested in becoming a volunteer or a young achiever yourself, please reach out to me. I will be holding an interest meeting after church December 3rd, which is the first Sunday in December, and I would love to see you all there. Thank you.
I think we prayed for our young adults to start doing some things for our church, and come on, somebody, I think some prayers are being answered. Hallelujah. I know my heart is on fire just thinking about all the possibilities and expectations for this church, for the members, for the young, for the students, and I just feel like it's a prayer answered. Amen. Amen, amen. I just have just a few announcements this morning. As Pastor said earlier this morning, today is All Saints Sunday. It's a day that we take time to acknowledge those who have passed in this past year from October to October. I just want to highlight Sister Sonia Offer, whose husband had passed away, and she wished that she could have been here. Just want to read her card real quick. She says, to the Asbury Town Neck Church family, I just want to say thank you. It seems like it doesn't seem enough. I hope you know just how much I appreciate you and who you really are, and that she's given a significant donation in honor and memory of her husband, Mr. Stanley Offer. Amen. Let's go. Amen, amen, amen. And in the interest of All Saints Day and acknowledging people that have passed, we grieve right now for Sister Jamira Tony, who passed this past Friday. Amen. And so, you know, Pastor said that sometimes passing is the ultimate healing. Amen. Certainly it is our loss, but it is God's gain. Amen, somebody. Amen. And if you know the Lord, come on, somebody. If you know the Lord, we celebrate. We're going to celebrate her life. So stay tuned. Arrangements for that is forthcoming. So I just want to say that the honor roll report cards, it's that time of season again. The men continue to seed into our youth of this church, acknowledging and rewarding our youth for their scholastic achievements. And I think they might need, after what Maya's doing, you guys might need to put some more money in the pot. And it looks like they're getting ready to get some encouragement on this end. Amen. Amen. I mentioned that just to say that having those ministry forms, the students having the ministry forms and copies of your report card have to be in November the 26th. That's homecoming Sunday. We extend an invitation also to you to join us for the pre-Thanksgiving service on Tuesday, November the 21st at 7, where we're coming together to collaborate and share fellowship with the pastor and members of Severna Park United Methodist Church. And Dr. Torrey will be delivering the message, the sermon for that evening, and the choirs from here will be actively participating in ministry. So that's November the 21st, Tuesday, November the 21st. And as you all know, it's our homecoming and church anniversary. We're celebrating how many years? 135. Amen, amen. And our theme is 135 reasons why we are still here. Amen. We'll be commemorating our past and inspiring, come on, the future. We will be having a banner out in the lobby area.
And what we are encouraging you to do is go in your boxes and pull out photos and pull out whatever memorabilia you can have. You can come put your hands on, tape it to the banner. Amen. And so we're just going to acknowledge just where we've come from and where we are right now. So we encourage you to do that. And so we just all have a lot to thank God for. Amen. Amen. It's the tradition of our church to give a dollar for every year that God has had us here and has blessed us. And since it's 135, we have envelopes for you to say that $135 for adults, $13.50 for the teens and the kids, $1.35. Amen. Everybody can take part. And as Brother Sam said last week, the donations that received this year for homecoming and in celebration of our 135-year anniversary will go towards our media project, and we will be getting our wall-mounted cameras. Amen. And so we just, amen. So Mike is and Darren and the whole media team are trying to put all of that together so that we can have that, and then we can have full use of our church once again. Amen, somebody. Amen. And if you can just take a look up, do you guys see our brand new projectors that we got in? Amen. Amen. We were having trouble. They were about to go out. We got full use of our old ones because, you know, we use stuff until it's dust. Okay? So, yeah. And unfortunately, what happened this time, it had dust and dots and we couldn't see things, so we had to take care of that. So we just want to let you see what we are doing. Come on with the donations here at this church. Amen. 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 And I just want to say another deadline that's coming up is the Christmas dinner. Brother Sam had mentioned about the Christmas dinner we're having at Olive Grove. It's open to the whole church. It's going to be on December the 12th, Tuesday at 6 o'clock. And so if you're interested, got to get those funds to him. There is a limit on the number of people that can be in the house at Olive Grove Restaurant. And so we just encourage you to make payments to him, or you can bring it to the church. You can write it to the church. But just know that it's not a contribution to the church. Amen? Amen, amen. So last but not least, I just want to say, just remember our prayer, as Brother Julius said. He said, don't complain. Come on, you need to pray. Amen. So join us on Wednesdays mornings at 8 o'clock. The conference call number is in your email and also posted on the church website. Amen. So that concludes the announcements for this morning.
Greetings, Asbury Townet family and friends. Welcome to the ATN Network. Luke chapter 6, verse 38 reads, give, and it will be given to you, a good measure, pressed down, shaken together, and running over, will be poured into your lap. For with the measure you use it, it will be measured to you. Therefore know, God takes whatever we give and multiplies it so that we can be blessed to be a blessing. Brothers and sisters, currently we have four ways to give. You can call 410-647-3461 to arrange an in-person drop-off. You can mail your tithes and your offerings to 429 Asbury Drive, Severna Park, Maryland, 21146. Or you can visit our website, asburytownneck.org, and click the donate button. Or you can use the Cash App at $ATNUMC. Thank you for your continual support of the ministries of Asbury Townet United Methodist Church. We invite you to continue to join us for worship and the Word.
Father God, we thank you for another opportunity, God, to be able to give back that which you give to us so generously, Lord God. And we just ask that you bless these tithes and these offerings, God, for the upbuilding and the advancement of your kingdom. It's in Jesus' name that we all pray. Amen and amen. stand for the offertory and remain standing for the scripture reading. Today's scripture reading will be coming from the Old Testament, Psalm 34, verses 1 through 10 and 22. I will extol the Lord at all times. His praise will always be on my lips. I will glory in the Lord. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. I sought the Lord, and he answered me. He delivered me from all of my fears. Those who look to him are radiant. Their faces are never covered with shame. This poor man called, and the Lord heard him. He saved him out of all of his troubles. The angel of the Lord encamps around those who fear him, and he delivers them. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. Fear the Lord, you his holy people, for those who fear him lack nothing. The lions may grow weary and hungry, but those who seek the Lord lack no good thing. The Lord will rescue his servants. No one who takes refuge in him will be condemned. The word of God for the people of God.
Lift them up.
Praise it so hard, I'm out of breath. Hallelujah. I know, right? I might have to put my flip-flops on in a second. Woo, I know, right? I'm trying to catch my breath, I really mean it. We give God thanks and praise because we want to lift high the name of Jesus. We want to lift God's name high because we know at the sound of the name of Jesus, demons begin to tremble and they have to flee. We understand that something happens when we call on the name of the Lord. We know that when we begin to call on the name of Jesus, we know that healing gets ushered in. We know that he is the resurrection and the life. We know that he was and will come back again. When we call on the name of God, we know that the atmosphere begins to shift. And when we begin to praise him, I just believe that just something happens when we ask the Spirit of the living God to not only rest upon us, but indwell us. I believe that there's some shifting happening in the atmosphere on today. Hallelujah, Jesus. Let us go to God in prayer this morning. The scripture's already been read, and I had a tame opening, so we're just gonna hope that my tame opening still goes. Lord God, we are so grateful. God, we thank you that we can continue to lift your name higher and higher, oh God. Because the word tells us if we look to the hills, we can look to the hills from whence cometh our help, and our help comes from you, God. And so, God, every time that we look up, God, we're just asking that you would remember us, God. God, we're asking that you would touch us, oh God. God, we're asking you to just move in our circumstances, God. God, we're asking you to breathe on us afresh, God. God, we're asking you to have your way in our lives. When we look up and continue to lift your name higher and higher. So, Lord God, on today, I just pray that your spirit would rest on your preacher. God, I pray on today that I would get out the way and that you, Holy Spirit, would have your way. And Lord, I'm just wanting to be used by you. God, I ask that you would just do only what you can do, oh God. And God, I pray on today for peace. And I pray that your will be done in this service. In Jesus' name, amen. Amen. If I had to give the sermon a title, I would call it The Welcome Table. The Welcome Table. There's an old gospel song that says, I'm going to sit at the welcome table. Y'all know that song? I'm going to sit at the welcome table one of these days. Some people add a hallelujah in there, right? I'm going to sit at the welcome table. Sit at the welcome table one of these days. One of these days. It's a gospel song that came out of the slave experience. It was a song that folk would sing because they wanted access to the master's table. They not only wanted access to the master's table, but they wanted freedom. They wanted to know what it tasted like to be free and to not be oppressed and not go through the things that they were going through. Like many of us today, we are still asking for access to a welcome table. We're still asking for access to education because we know that affirmative action policies are in place or not in place anymore. And we're asking for access to housing. If you live in Anne Arundel County, you know that black folk have the lowest ownership rate out of everybody because the housing market has gotten priced out, y'all. We're still asking for access to medical services because I know there's some folk in here that can't pay their medication bills because it's too high. I don't know about you, but some of us are asking for access to a welcome table that God has guaranteed us. Now, David didn't just want access to a welcome table. David wanted access to God's power and God's authority and God's safety. Well, Pastor, well, what's going on? Because typically, we don't necessarily hear anybody preach from the Psalms unless they are preaching Psalm 23. ain't that the truth, right? So let me set the scene for you. Psalm 34, it has like a little superscript. It says, of David. That means David wrote it. Not every psalm in the book of Psalms David wrote, okay? So typically we have a little bit of a notation that lets us know actually who wrote the psalm. So David wrote this, and it literally says when he pretended to be insane before Abimelech, who drove him away and he left. First of all, it wasn't even Abimelech. They kind of messed up there. There was a guy named Achish. And if you don't know what I'm talking about, go to 1 Samuel chapter 21. All right, I'm going to set that up for you. So David is writing this psalm after he has been running for his life. Let me break that down. We all know that David was just a little kid who had a slingshot and a couple of rocks and took down Goliath. We know that story, right? Y'all remember that from Sunday school, Vacation Bible School, right? Amen? So we get to a point after he has taken out Goliath and his fame in all the land gets so great, now he's a threat to Saul, who is the current king of Israel. And so although David commits his life to Saul, Saul got a little problem with David. He can't handle his jealousy, y'all. And it doesn't help that the people are shouting out in the streets, Saul killed 1,000, but David killed 10,000. So it doesn't help that the people are kind of shouting David's name. And so Saul gets in his little feelings, and it actually says he goes a little insane in the text, and then he has a plot to kill David. Y'all with me? All right. So in the process of him plotting to kill David, David begins to run for his life, and he finds himself in a place called Gath. And while he's there, he pretends to be insane so that the king of Gath don't kill him. But then he recognized, isn't this the guy that they were singing a song about? So in the process of him pretending to be insane so that the king doesn't kill him, he writes this psalm. Y'all with me? So in the midst of it all, he begins, I will extol the Lord at all times. His praise will be on my lips. I will glory in the Lord. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. Glorify the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. I'm going to pause real quick. He's in the midst of being chased, y'all. Don't miss this. In the midst of him running for his very life, he takes a moment and begins to worship God. I think there's a lesson in there for us. In the midst of when the enemy is coming at us, in the midst when times get hard, in the midst of when we are pressed down on every side and we don't know what to do or know what to turn, we can look to David who says, I will extol the Lord at all times. His praise will continually be on my lips. I will glory in the Lord. Let the afflicted hear and rejoice. I want to pause right there. It says, let the afflicted hear. David is saying, guess what? Not all of us have some pain that we deal with, y'all. And since this is All Saints Sunday, some of y'all are dealing with some grief that is just too much for you to bear. But the word tells us, let the afflicted hear and rejoice. Glorify the name of the Lord with me. Let us exalt his name together. There is something that happens when we begin to decree and declare good things. We're not only trying to confuse the enemy, we're trying to tell ourselves that God is up to something good in the midst of our pain, y'all. We're reminding ourselves that God has not forgotten us, that God has not left us, that God has not forsaken us. And while we say, I will yet praise him, because the scripture tells me, let us extol the Lord. If you don't know what extol means, let us praise God. Let's lift his name higher and higher at all times. Can we get real this morning? Sometimes we don't got a praise left. Can we go there today? Sometimes we are so afflicted, we are so tired, we're so confused, we're just so broken and lonely and all of these different things. We don't got a praise left. Can we just go there this morning? Some of us can't get to you, and I will bless the Lord at all times, and his praise shall continually be in my mouth. That's why we come to church. Can I go there this morning, and I'll get back to all of this? That's why we come to church, y'all. We come to church because church is not just an individual experience of God. Church is a communal experience of God. We come to be in the fellowship of other people because on the day when the affliction gets too much for us to bear, there is somebody there that's going to praise God for us until we can get there where we can say, I'm going to bless God with all my heart and all my soul and all my strength. We come to church so that we know that in the midst of our suffering, we are not by ourselves. We come to church because there is somebody in here that says, you don't got to go through this alone. I'm going to take hold of your hand and remind you that God is with you, that God has not forsaken you, that God is walking in the valley with you, that you're going to come out on the other side because God sees something in you. God knows your pain. God knows exactly what you're going through. And I'm going to keep praying and praising until you get there. Until you can get to the place where you say, I'm going to bless the God at all times and his praises shall continually be in my mouth. But I also want to say that David doesn't start and end this psalm with a praise, y'all. Because this is a psalm of lament. He also goes into petition. And I like this part because sometimes we don't think we can ask God about anything. Sometimes we limit our prayer lives, or we're asking for things that maybe God could direct us a little bit better, right? But nevertheless, this is what I love about David. He said, I sought the Lord and God answered me. Can we pause and just say that God does answer your prayers? God does hear your prayers. God does hear the cries of your heart. God hears your groanings that are too deep for words. God hears you when you are crying in the midnight hour. God sees you in the midst of your grief. God knows you in the midst of your anxiety. God sees you in the midst of your depression. God sees you in the midst of your illness. God sees you when you think you don't have anything left. God knows. God knows when you are on the edge. God knows when your well is dried up. Am I on anybody's street this morning? God knows when you don't have anything else to pour out. God knows when you're empty asking God to fill you. God knows. But in the midst of this, it reminds us that even in the midst of God knowing, we can still seek after God, because it says, I sought the Lord. Because sometimes when we get in the midst of our depression, when we get in the midst of our anxiety, when we get in the midst of being pressed on every side, we don't want to talk to God because we're afraid of God's response. The word says, and yet he delivered me from all of my fears. So you don't have to be fearful about how God is going to respond. Because he will answer, y'all. It says, those who look to him are radiant. Their faces are never covered with shame. That means that even in our darkest hour, we don't have to be shameful. We don't have to be regretful. We don't have to worry about being judged. We don't have to worry about being perfect before God. If we are crying and are a hot mess because it's just too much for us to bear, we can go to God with snot coming down our nose and runny eyes and bloodshot eyes and our clothes not looking good. We not smelling good. Whatever's going on in our lives, we can come to God in our full selves and know that God sees you. The word says this poor man called and the Lord heard him. He saved him out of his trouble. In other words, God can take our pain and turn it into purpose. You don't have to stay there, y'all. Miss Debbie, would you raise your hand just really quickly? I want everybody to turn around in the sanctuary. You can see Miss Debbie's hand raised. Amen. I'm asking Miss Debbie to raise her hand because we have a grief ministry at our church. And I just wanna just shout out the grief ministry on today, because maybe on today you are in a place of grief that is just so overwhelming for you and you don't have a place to go or to turn. See Miss Debbie after church, and they meet every first Thursday of the month. First Tuesday. They meet every first Tuesday of the month online. So even if you are visiting us online and live afar, you can still join the grief ministry, because we believe that there is something that something happens when we come together and share our grief. There is healing there. I don't want to miss an opportunity to say that, because maybe you've been dealing with grief not just for 1 year. Maybe it's been two. Maybe it's been three. Maybe it's been five. Maybe it's been 25. I don't know, but there is a community here that's willing to walk with you through your pain, because the Lord sends his angels to encamp around us, and it says those who fear him, he delivers them. And he's not talking about fear in the sense of that fear and trembling. He's talking about reverence. He's talking about those who have respect for God, those who want to acknowledge God, those who are paying attention how God is moving in the atmosphere, those who God, who are just saying, Lord, I know that you're real. God delivers them. And then when we get back to this welcome table part, because I think this is one of the best parts of the whole scripture, it says, taste and see that the Lord is good. Blessed is the one who takes refuge in him. When we're talking about sitting at a welcome table that God offers us, we're talking about tasting and seeing that God is good, but we're also saying, God, we thank you that you have a seat for us at this table. God, we thank you that you always give us a glimpse of your glory. God, we thank you that we can know that no matter how the world turns its back on us, you never turn your back on us.
No matter how many times we've fallen down, we get up. God, that you continue to say, no matter how bad I was, how unclean I was, how bad I acted out, how many times I didn't pray, how many times I didn't come to church, how many times I didn't worship, how many times I didn't go to Bible study, you still say there is a seat at the table. Because even what? Even me, Lord. Even me. Don't you know that there is a seat at God's table for you? Do you know that that song that the old saints used to say, I'm going to sit at the welcome table one of these days? It was a reminder to those that there was a God who wouldn't allow them to stay in pain for the rest of their lives. That there was a God who had a welcome table waiting for them, that they didn't have to wait in line to get to, that once they got there, there was an open chair for them to sit down at. Do you know that there is a God who loves you that much? That he bled and died on an old rugged cross so that you could taste and see that he was indeed good and that his mercies endure forever. Don't you know that every time we come to this communion table, y'all, it's a welcoming table. Every time that we come to communion, y'all, it's a welcoming table. It's an opportunity for all those who feel unincluded to be included. It's a reminder that this is an invitation for you to participate in the life and ministry of God. It's a reminder that God sees you, that God knows you, and it doesn't matter how good or not good you've been. The table is always open to receive you because there is a God who's always giving you an invitation for you to taste and see that he is indeed good and that his mercies endure forever. Won't you come to this welcome table on today? Won't you take this seriously on today? This welcome table is for you. Do you know that? Do you know that today? That the bread is for you, that the juice is for you, the bread being the body of Christ, that is God's body broken for you over 2,000 years ago, the juice, the wine, the grape juice in the Methodist church is a reminder of the blood of Christ shed for you so that you might know what it means for somebody to give their very life for you. So I typically don't do an invitation on first Sundays because I feel like the communion table is an invitation. But I'm going to pause and just say, is there anybody in here? Is there anybody in here who has not felt welcomed by God or welcomed by the church? Is there anybody in here who at this time just needs to know that there is a God who knows you by your name? Who says that you are worthy? Who sees you in the depths of your pain. If you would like to know this saving God, I just ask that you would come to the altar and kneel, and we'll pray the prayer of salvation with you. For those who may want to rededicate your life to Jesus, that means maybe you've been in a place where you've just been a little disconnected and you want to reconnect. I just invite you to come to the altar and we would love to pray with you on today. And then finally, I'm just asking if you just need some prayer. Maybe your heart is broken. I just don't know. But you know. Maybe your heart is broken today. And maybe you're just at a place where you're like, God, I just need you to hear me. The altar is open. Would you come? I'm going to give folks some time because I just really do feel like in my spirit that there are some people who need some prayer on today. Hallelujah. Craig, would you come and sing something for us? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We just want to come and pray. And for those of you who are sitting in the audience and those of you who are online, we invite you to pray with us. Or just maybe choose somebody that's at the altar and just begin to ask God to be with them. You may not know what they're going through, but you know that there is a God who knows and sees them. Minister Carla, will you come down and help me minister to the people? Thank you so much.
Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus is the best thing I've ever done. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus. Falling in love with Jesus is the best thing I've ever, ever done. In his arms I feel protected. In his arms never disconnected. In his arms, I feel protected. There's no place I'd rather be. In his arms, I feel protected. In his arms, never disconnected. In his arms, I feel protected. There's no place I'd rather be.
Brother Ray. Connected in his arms,
step. There's no place I'd rather be.
Amen. At any point in the service, if you find that you just need to stay at the altar, you can just come and stay there. We're not going to mess with you. Amen. Because sometimes we just need to get to the altar. We don't even know why, but we just need to get there. Amen. Amen. I'm going to try my best to... We're going to modify a little bit, so I need y'all to go with me. During our communion liturgy, we are going to acknowledge the saints that have passed away. So I just want to give everyone a little bit of a heads up. So when you hear the name of your family member called, the name will be called, you'll hear a bell, but as soon as you hear the name called, the family of that person, please stand. Family and friends that may have come to recognize that person, would you please stand? You'll hear their name. Their picture will be on the screen. You'll hear a bell. We'll light a candle. Amen? Amen. Brothers and sisters, Christ invites all to the table, all who love him, all who earnestly repent of their sin. In the name of Jesus Christ, you are forgiven on this day. Brothers and sisters, I pray that you would hear the good news that Christ died for us while we are yet sinners, and that proves God's amazing love for us. It is right and a good and joyful thing always and everywhere to give thanks to God Almighty. He's the creator of heaven and earth. You got to speed up, Mike, for me. I'm skipping around a little bit. And if you don't get it, that's okay. The God of Abraham and Sarah, the God of Miriam and Moses, the God of Joshua and Deborah, the God of Ruth and David, the God of the priests and the prophets, the God of Mary and Joseph, the God of the apostles and the martyrs, the God of our mothers and our fathers, the God of our children to all generations. And so with your people on earth and all the company of heaven, we praise your name and join their unending hymn.
Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Amen. Brothers and sisters, holy are you and blessed is your son, Jesus Christ. By the baptism of his suffering, death, and resurrection, you gave birth to your church, delivered us from slavery to sin and death, and made with us a new covenant by water and the Spirit. On the night in which Jesus gave himself up for us, he took the bread in his hands and he broke it, saying, "This is the body broken for you. And every time that you eat of this, do this in remembrance of me." When the supper was over, he took the cup in his hands and gave thanks to his Father in heaven and said, "This is the blood of the new covenant, poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of the sins of the world. And every time that you drink of this, do this in remembrance of me." And so in remembrance of these, your mighty acts in Jesus Christ, we offer ourselves in praise and thanksgiving as a holy and living sacrifice in union with Christ's offering for us, as we proclaim the mystery of faith together. Pour out your Holy Spirit upon us gathered here and on these gifts of bread and the fruit of the vine. Make them be for us the body and blood of Christ, so that we may be for the world the body of Christ, redeemed by his blood. As we now renew our communion with all the saints, we now name them before you in your care, O God. So again, as you hear your family's name being called, would you please stand? Miss Bertha Cager.
There we go. Amen. You may be seated. Miss Luella Wilburn. Amen. 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 Mr. Ike Wallace. Miss Ann Anderson. Do we have another one? Set. Try that one. Okay. There you go. All right. Miss Elizabeth White. Mr. Michael Bass. Miss Helen Jennings. Mr. Stanley Offer. And we finally light a candle for all the names that we know and all that we don't. And so if you have anybody that you've lost this year that we have not lifted up at this time, you may stand as we light our final candle. Amen. Amen. To God be the glory. Since we are so surrounded by such a great cloud of witnesses, strengthen us to run with perseverance the race that is set before us. Looking to Jesus, the pioneer and perfecter of our faith, by your Spirit make us one with Christ, one with each other, and one in ministry to all the world until Christ comes in final victory and we feast at his heavenly banquet table. That welcome table, y'all, that we talked about. Through your Son, Jesus Christ, and the Holy Spirit and your holy church, all honor and glory is yours, Almighty God, now and forever. Amen. And now with the boldness of children of God, let us pray the prayer our Savior continues to teach us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Amen. At this time, we invite everybody to take out the bread. You got a little cup in your hand. We want to remind everybody that this is an open table. So even if you haven't been to church for a while, you can participate in communion, because remember, this is the welcome table. This is a table that all can participate in. Amen. Would you take the bread in your hands at this time? This is the body of Christ broken for you. Won't we take and eat together? Everybody good to go? This is the blood of Christ shed for you. Won't we take and drink together? Amen. Amen. Will you pray with me one more time? It seemed like, amen. God, we give you thanks and praise for all that you have done for us. And so, Lord, we just ask that you'll continue to bless us in a mighty way and continue to welcome us at your heavenly table. In Jesus' name, amen. Would you stand on your feet one more time? We're going to do a benediction. And if the praise team or would like to come forward to offer us one final selection, we invite you to do so. Will you raise one hand or two hands unto God? God, we thank you for the saints that have gone before us. God, we thank you for all those that we have named today in your care. And God, we thank you that they're watching from heaven and asking you, oh God, to take care of us while they wait to see us again. And so, Lord Jesus, I pray on this day that you would strengthen us, that you would guide us, that you would protect us, and that you would remind us that there is a table that has a seat with our names on it. And all we have to do is just call on the name of Jesus, and he is willing to give us access to the table of salvation. And so, God, we give you thanks and praise for that. And so we're going to sit at the welcome table, not just one of these days, but right now. In Jesus' name, amen.
For a saint is just a sinner who